to approach Nepantla, because Nepantla is really difficult. It's so abstract. It maps out this kind of in-between space that's beyond categories, or in between categories. But words are categories, right? So if something's beyond words, how do you talk about it?
Well, maybe this is what you can say what it isn't. So we're going to try to start approaching Nepantla this way. I'm going to show,
first of all, binaries, you know, cool, not cool, most people are like, oh, they're not cool.
They're too simple, it's oppositional, creates a hierarchy, deterministic, a sense of closure.
But feminist scholars and narratologists, Robin Warhol, has talked about this instead of binaries, approaching it as a doubling. So not either or, but kind of this overlap. Not as opposed, but as coexisting. So not one or the other, but both. So this is starting to get closer to Nepantla. Without resting comfortably in either of the two terms being opposed. So, this is more of a Nepantla idea. Right,
there's some more text there, but moving on.
So, Nepantla is not a binary, and it is not liminality, which is made famous by Victor Turner. And liminality is a beautiful concept, but this is, it has to do with temporality, Victor Turner's definition of liminality. So there's one kind of stable category, and then there's this rite of passage, there's a kind of liminal space, and then another stable category. And after giving birth, there's a famous example where there's a woman gives birth, there's a liminal space, and then a mother. So there's a woman, mother, liminal space, giving birth. Now, there's this wonderful book by James Matthew called Aztec Philosophy, Understanding the World in Motion, and he talks a lot about Nepantla, because Nepantla comes from the Aztec. It's Aztec, a Nahuatl word from the Aztecs. And Nepantla was integral to how Aztecs understood the cosmos. And the Aztecs understood everything is constantly in flux. There is no anything behind it. Everything is in movement. The metaphor they use, it's a weaving. This up and down and across. And James Matthey really straightforwardly writes about this completely different metaphysical premise in a way that, for me, was very understandable. So he says that Aztecs understood the cosmos as flux and change in movement. And in-betweenness, in other words, are the ordinary states